Hi everyone, and welcome to this video where I'll show you how to build a simple stochastic model in Excel. This can be used to model uncertainty, such as trying to predict sales for a given product. We'll start by building a probability table to identify the likelihood of each outcome. We'll then generate random numbers using the RAND function and retrieve the output using VLOOKUP. Next, we will check the accuracy of our random numbers and finally incorporate it into our model to forecast sales in a year. To start, we're going to assume that sales in each month can either be 100, 250, 400, or 550. We're also going to assume that the probability of sales being 100 is 10% or 0.1, the probability of sales being 250 is 0.5, the probability of sales being 400 is 0.25, and the probability of sales being 550 is 0.15. Next, we must calculate the cumulative probabilities to find the probability that a value falls within a specified range. The reason for doing this will become clearer in step 2. The first cumulative probability is 0. The next one is the previous cumulative probability plus the current probability, and so on. Now that we've built our probability table, we can proceed to step 2, where we generate a random number between 0 and 1, and then calculate the sales figure that would correspond to it. To calculate the random number, we can use the RAND function. As you can see, Excel has retrieved a random number between 0 and 1. Next, we can use VLOOKUP to calculate which sales figure this corresponds to. So we type equals VLOOKUP, we're looking up the random value within the probability table we've built. Note that we're just using the last two columns of the table, as we're looking up the random value in the cumulative probability column, not the probability column. Next, we type 2, as we want to retrieve the sales figure, which is in the second column within our range. Finally, we type true, as we want an approximate match. Therefore, for this random number, the corresponding sales figure would be 550. This is because 0.94 is between 0.85 and 1, and therefore corresponds to 550. Next, we can test the validity of our approach. Here we want to check that the occurrences generated are as close as possible to the theoretical probabilities in column B. To do this, we must first insert the sales figures that we're looking for. To calculate the frequency of each sales figure, we can use COUNTIF. So we're counting how many times the value 100 has been retrieved within column G. We can then bring this down to the below cells. The total occurrences can be found using the sum function. We can then convert the frequency into a percentage by taking the frequency and dividing it by the total number of occurrences. Don't forget to add absolute references here, so this cell remains selected when we bring this formula down. Right now, these percentages do not match our theoretical probabilities because we don't have enough occurrences to draw from. However, as we increase the occurrences, the percentages in column K will become more similar to the probabilities in column B. Let's test this out by firstly adding absolute references to this range here and then dragging this formula down. As you can see, the probability of the output being 100 is now close to 10%. The probability of the sales figure being 250 is close to 50%, and so on. In general, the more occurrences that we have, the closer they will resemble the theoretical probabilities over here. Next, we can integrate our stochastic model to forecast the sales for the coming year. So once again, we can use the RAND function to generate random numbers between 0 and 1. Next, let's use VLOOKUP to calculate the sales figures. So we're looking up the random number within the probability table we made earlier. Let's not forget to add absolute references over here. We're looking to retrieve the value in the second column, and we want the last component of the VLOOKUP function to be true. Therefore, our model predicts that sales will be 250 in January and February, 400 in March, 250 in April again, and so on. So that's how you can set up a simple stochastic model to simulate uncertainty in Excel. Please give this video a thumbs up if you found it useful, and subscribe to the Excel Hub for weekly Excel tutorials, techniques, and examples.